Hello, welcome back to Jacob's Toys. Please do like, share, subscribe and all of those things. All support to the channel is very much appreciated. And Fan Home have delivered my next delivery of my build and Optimus Prime. And I'm very excited because I've got a whole bunch of issues here. We've got issue 12, we've got issue 13, we've got issue 14, we've got issue 15. And of course we have issue 16. So that is 5 more pieces to the builder figure. And in this particular video, we are going to be looking at issue 13.
Not wasting any time at all, moving on to issue 13. And as always, it focuses on a particular character from the movie series. You then have a little bit of a feature on particular characters and various different parts to the cartoon and the movies and the animation. And then sometimes it talks about toys as well, like the old retro toys. And then you've got a step-by-step instruction. Now, these instructions are good and are well worth following because they're visual. They've got everything labelled up nicely, but there's also a written explanation as to what you're doing as well. Now, for the sake of the speed of the video, I have sped this up so that you can kind of see, because it does take a little bit of time. And this is a die-cast model, so some of the parts of it are made out of metal, some of it are made out of plastic. What's nice is it tends to be that in most of your issues, there is a metal piece of some kind. I find this particular bit quite fiddly because you've got these kind of little rivet kind of washer pieces that you've got to put in place. Now, make sure that you've got grooves on the outside. That's something that it does mention in the written text of the instruction manual, because it kind of creates that friction and that kind of clicking element of the joints and stuff. Now, as you can see, we are starting to build up one of the right legs, so it's taken quite a few issues so far even just to get to this stage. And it's my understanding that for the next kind of 9 or 10 issues, we're going to be building up that right leg, which is cool because we've already completed the foot. So to have the leg and to be able to put the leg and the foot together is very cool. One thing that does frustrate me with subscription services sometimes is when they kind of build it from north, south, east, west, and you're kind of building up all these various different little bits and you're just sat with piles of stuff for, you know, weeks and weeks and weeks. It doesn't seem to be the case with this one. It does seem to be that we're kind of building on something we've done previously. The first few issues, it was very much the head and then a little bit of the chest, and then it went on to the foot. And since then, we've kind of built the foot up, we've moved on to the leg, and then it's my understanding that the next handful of issues are going to be the leg as well. Now, we're introduced to a new tool in this particular issue. It's this little spanner kind of thing. I found it quite fiddly, I'm not going to lie, but for the sake of the video, I'm using the tool that they've provided. But I suppose if you've got a decent pair of pliers or something, you could use those as well. But essentially, you've got nuts that you need to make sure are tightened up and in place, and they've provided you a little wrench to do that. So it does work, it's just it's very small, so it's quite fiddly. Putting a couple more of those washers in. You can see there's a couple of bits there from the last issue on that top part of the leg. And I think from what I can gather, this is going to be like the knee joint that we're starting to work on here. So there is articulation in the figure. It's not just a solid statue. There is a lot of articulation, as we saw previously in the foot. There was a lot of moving parts in the foot. And it looks like the leg and the knee is going to be very similar. And there's going to be quite a bit of articulation there as well, which is really cool, especially for display. I can't imagine it's going to be articulated the same way as like an action figure would be. But to be able to kind of put it into a few different positions and have it positioned slightly different to other collectors, that is quite a plus in my opinion. Now, I've read online as well a couple of people commenting about the amount of time that this subscription service takes and the amount of kind of money obviously invested. But one thing I will definitely say is every single issue, it's so detailed. There's no unsculpted parts. It's all the angles are all right, the cogs, the gears, and there's so much hidden underneath other parts. It almost seems like a bit of a shame sometimes when I'm going through and I'm putting bits on top of other bits where it's taken me kind of a whole issue or two issues to kind of put that together. And you can see all the intricate parts there within even just this leg are going to be covered up with parts from future issues. So it's very multi-layered, and I think it definitely works in the favour of the subscription service to know how detailed this model is. These pliers are mine, they're not supplied, but it does say use a pair of pliers to get that little bar in. But yeah, there we go, finished.
Thank you very much for watching. I'm loving seeing this figure come to life and kind of build up. I've seen pictures of it online finished and it is huge and I cannot wait to get there. Thank you very much for watching. Please do like, share, subscribe and all of those things. I'll see you soon.